Satan's power. Remember Paul says, if our gospel be hidden, is hidden to them who are blind? That's spiritual blindness. Who the God of this world has what?
Blind.
Blind where?
Their mind.
So they can't see.
Amen.
They're spiritual blind. So when a person is spiritual blind, they can't move. They don't make progress. They don't make progress because they're spiritual blind.
Amen.
The solution for darkness is light.
Amen.
The only solution for darkness is light. See, anytime you have a dark situation, the only solution is to get the word of God and begin to speak light.
Amen.
To every dark areas that are in your life, you need to speak light.
Amen.
So when the word comes in, what happens? The word lights up you. Then God starts making stuff and putting it in the earth. Look how good God is. My brother, God in Genesis chapter 3, in chapter 1, verse 3. God said, let there be light, and the light was not the sunlight, it was the glory light. That means the whole earth was lit up by the glory light. There was no sun, there was no moon, there was nothing. There was only the glory of God. The first thing God did is reveal His glory.
Amen.
And His glory comes out of Him, because anything that comes out of God is living.
Amen.
It's alive and it's eternal. That's why His word is incorruptible.
Amen.
That means it's living and abides forever, because everything that comes out of Him is eternal and cannot die. Hallelujah. When God gave it to make man, God didn't say that. God didn't. When God gave it to create man, God didn't went to the ground first. He came to Himself first.
Amen.
He took man out of Himself. And then He gave man body. Because man can exercise legal in a physical dimension, man need to have a physical vessel.
Hallelujah.
So He gave man a body. He shaped man, He formed man, and then He blew.
Hallelujah.
Blow Himself in man. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Then man became a living soul. Man stood up.
Amen.
My God, man was alive and full of glory.
Amen.
Man covered with glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's not just nakedness. Amen. I mean, most people think that when the man sinned, then the man finally was naked. Naked is not that. It has nothing to do with clothes. That means they were stripped from the glory. The glory leave when they sin.
Yes, sir.
And that's what happened. Anytime a person sin, the glory leave.
Yes, sir.
Man was clothed with the glory of God. You remember the Psalms 8, David 8? What David says in Psalm 8. He says that the angel says, who is man that thou so mindful of, and who is son of man that thou art crowned with what?
And
what?
And the mercy.
So man had a what? Crown, that man, glory. So when man said the glory is stripped. So Jesus now, when man didn't fell from the image of God, man fell from the likeness of God. Man still looked like God, but man wasn't operating like God. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus came and He was the sign of the word. He was the sign of the word. Not to restore the image, just to restore the likeness.
Amen.
What He did, how could He restore the likeness? He had to what? He had to pay the price first.
Yes.
When He paid the price now, He quickens you.
Amen.
He quickens your spirit.
Amen.
That's the part of Him, you that comes out of Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So your spirit comes alive.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And come right back in the rightful place. What is the rightful place? The presence of God. Because man was made for the presence of God. Move the presence of God, you move the mind. The mind becomes chaos. Man start killing people.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Man start killing people. Man start taking all kinds of drugs. Man start doing all kinds of things.
Yeah, that's true.
Because why? Only the presence of God will keep the mind stable.
Amen, that's true.
Because the mind was made for the presence of God. When the mind comes to the presence of God, the mind becomes dysfunction. And everything out of him becomes dysfunction.
Amen.
When Adam came in the presence of God, their son came out of him, and the son came out of dysfunction.
Yeah.
Amen.
They didn't have to teach the son how to kill. Automatically, the spirit of murder was right in him.
My God.
And jealousy.
Yes.
Because man came out of his place. God made a man what? The people in the what? In his presence.
Yes.
In his presence. Amen. And Eden is not a... Eden is not, we say, well, Eden is a garden. Yeah. It's a garden, amen. He said it's a garden. But Eden also is an open door. Man had an open door to God. There was no distance between God and man. God lived with man and man lived with God. Man didn't have to pray. Man never had no headache. Man didn't have to worry. Man didn't have to just live in the presence of God.
Amen.
And as long as this man is in the presence of God, this man was able to live for eternity.
Amen.
But when he sinned, he became a normal man.
Yes.
That can die.
Amen.
But the Bible never tells us how long that this man was in the presence of God before he sinned.
That's true.
It never, there's no evidence.
That's right.
So this man could have been in the presence of God for many years before he sinned. God is so awesome.
Amen.
God created man in Genesis 1. You see, in the reason for man. And Genesis 2, the duty and the responsibility of man being created. So I mean, man had an assignment when God created him. Man had an assignment. Look, the devil so mad because, sing to God, the devil is not like you. He's not like you. He's not like me.
Amen.
And because God fired him and hired you, he's jealous.
That's true.
Because now we have the rights to worship God in spirit and truth. That was his job.
My God.
He was a shepherd for whom that the Bible says he had many instruments on him. He was the choir all by himself.
My God.
But when he would lift up, when he became proud, lift up in pride, because pride seeks the glory that he had.
Yeah.
And then how crazy you gonna be. If somebody make you, you know that person make you can destroy you.
That's true.
That's true.
All the world you can think that you can exalt yourself.
That's true.
Over and above the Creator. How? How? If the Creator make you, created you, the Creator can kill you.
Amen. That's
this is why God didn't fight Lucifer. If God had fight Lucifer, there would be no more Lucifer.
That's true.
God don't fight his creation. He's bigger than that. God
Amen.
Michael, get it. He's not in my class.
That's true.
Because if God will touch him, you'll have no more Lucifer.
Amen.
All of them are dead. Destroyed. Wipe away. Because there's no one in the class of God.
Amen.
God didn't even come down low to fight him. Because they got somebody to fight you. Michael!
That's true, man.
Amen. They drive the enemy, the devil, and the turtle, the angel out of heaven. Amen. That the enemy deceived. You saw how fast he get deceived?
Don't take much.
Satan need a legal right. Without a legal right, he could not get to eat.
Amen.
Amen.
Because a spirit without a body is
illegal.
Yes. A spirit cannot operate in this physical dimension without a body. Yes. This is why he went in the serpent.
Yes.
The serpent lent Lucifer his body.
Mm-hmm.
And Lucifer was operating through the serpent.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. In order to talk to Eve, he had to possess a body. That was impossible for him to talk to Eve in the spirit.
Amen.
Do you believe that? Do you believe that stronghold tonight is going to be loose? We believe that. We can believe that death cancellation is going to take place.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, we believe that loved one is going to come to the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Before we go to this, we're going to read three scriptures. Amen. This is going to be where we're going to, amen, we're going to use these as the foundation. As you remember, it says, prayer without the word is not prayer. The word must be the foundation of prayer. Every prayer must be based on scripture. And if it's not based on the word, then you're complaining. Amen. So it must be based on the word of God. Amen. The first one is Isaiah 49 and verse 24 and 25. Isaiah 49 verse 24 and 25. Isaiah 49, verse 24 and 25.
All right. Isaiah chapter 49,
Verse
24, you said, Pastor?
Yes, 24 and 25.
Okay. Isaiah 49, 24-25, you'll find these words. Shall the prey be taken? Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered?
You hear that?
Man.
So this is what we can believe in God for tonight.
Yes.
We are going to believe that God is going to deliver us.
Amen. Amen.
That whoever is bound in bondage, they are going to be delivered tonight in Jesus' name when we get to pray. Who believe that?
Hallelujah.
Who believe that when we get to pray that they are going to be deliverance? They are going to be manifestation.
Amen.
Amen. And most of all, God is going to get glory. God
Amen.
Is going to get glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, verse 25. Uh-huh. But thus says the Lord.
And thus says the Lord.
Even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away.
My God.
And the prey of the terrible shall be delivered.
You hear that?
For I will contend with him that contendeth with thee. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
My God. You
hear that? Hallelujah.
My God.
Amen.
Do you really get it?
He shall contend.
He said he will contend
yes.
with them that contend with you.
Amen. Amen. That's true.
If they don't want God to contend with them that contend with you.
Amen.
Amen.
That's powerful.
Glory to God. Yes. That's the benefit that the believers have. We have this benefit.
That's how much you love us. Thank
That's
you.
Right. Hallelujah.
We are precious in his sight.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
It's on Jeremiah 29:11.
All right. Familiar one. Jeremiah 29:11. All right. Let's see. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you,
oh, Jesus.
Says the Lord.
You hear that? God is talking to you.
Amen.
Sings of God. God is talking to you. He said he knows the thought that he thinks about you.
Amen.
Now, what kind of thought?
Good and not of evil.
Good
yeah.
and not of evil. That's why he said, no evil can dwell where you dwell.
Amen.
No evil can dwell in the same house where you dwell. No evil can dwell nigh me. I get no evil, no evil, no evil, no evil, no evil.
No evil.
Hallelujah. No evil. Somebody said no evil.
No evil.
Hallelujah. No evil can dwell where I dwell.
No evil.
Hallelujah. God knows the thoughts that he thinks towards me. Hallelujah.
To give you an expected end. Thank
oh,
you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Somebody, you're not going to be charged.
Amen.
God says. God says, I want to give you a what?
Expected
end.
Yes.
It doesn't matter how the beginning looks.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how you started, who started yes. before. But he says, I'm going to give you an expected end.
Lord.
That means, like, yeah, you're going to make it to the end.
Amen.
You are going to make it to the end. Ain't nothing can stop you from getting to the end. Why? Because God already saved you.
He already knows.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God already do it. Amen. It's already been done.
Hallelujah.
I said, God already do it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Let's go to Jeremiah, the 30, chapter 30, verse 23 and 24.
Jeremiah chapter 30.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay. Praise the Lord. And what was that verse, Pastor?
We can start from verse 23 and 24.
Okay, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 23. Okay. Behold, the whirlwind of the Lord.
Okay, now sing to God. Here comes it. You can control the elements, you know.
Yeah.
I said you can control the elements. The elements is, the wind is one of the elements. And if you don't control it, then the devil controls it to bring disaster upon the earth. God has given man authority and dominion over the elements. The wind is one of the elements.
All right.
Hallelujah. You remember in Acts chapter 2, God used the wind.
Yes,
the
right.
Bible says that when they all is in one place,
Amen.
A mighty rushing wind.
Amen.
And the reason why the writer says that there's a mighty rushing wind, because there was no way, no word to describe how powerful the wind was. So the man only can say that it was a mighty rushing wind.
Amen.
That was the only way he can describe
the power of the wind that when, when they was baptized with fire.
Yes.
Amen. So wind belongs to God. Your Bible says that, amen, that David says in the Psalms that the Lord rides on the wind of the wind.